Well, welcome again to Bajan TV. And today we want to talk about crap over and Christianity. And for years now, some Christians have been criticizing the festival, particularly when it has to do with certain types of music, the lyrics, and I guess the skimpy costumes and so on that we see on Doomsday Day. And I guess that's a negative aspect of the festival. But for the most part, the festival is positive, and as a black West Indian from Barbados, I enjoy the festival. I think that it has its place in our history and in our future. You know, as I said, as black people who form part of the African diaspora, whose great grandparents were slaves, okay, it is symbolic. And I think that it should be embraced by all peoples, whether they be white, black, green, Catholic, Anglican, and so on, because it is part of our history, you know. And I am of the opinion that in heaven, okay, because there's this set of people in Christian circles who think that in heaven, when they go up there, they will be singing Amazing Grace and so on, okay? But we don't know the type of music that's in heaven. A lot of the songs that we sing in our churches, that is Eurocentric, European, American pop, essentially, okay? When people like Sandy Patty and others sing, yeah, the lyrics are gospel, but again, the melody of those songs and so on, the genre of music is essentially pop R&B style, and maybe different variations of the song. But essentially, that's what it is. But we have no problem singing that in church, okay? But from the time people hear gospel lipso, hey, they say that can't work in the church, you know. But we need to embrace calypso, because that art form came out of our experience, just like the Negro spirituals came out of the experiences of the American slaves. So we need to embrace crop over the festival, the music, partly especially the music that is uplifting and speaks on issues of the day, and also speaks on issues that affect us in our everyday life. So I think that Christians should embrace crap over instead of criticizing it. And my thing is that from the inception of the festival, whenever that was, that Christians should have been there up front as a guide, the spiritual guide, our spiritual guides, okay, directing the festival, so that it would not run into the state that it's in, where it is strictly emphasis on commercialism and sex and gyrating and all that, you know, that goes along with the day. The Christian should have been there in the beginning as a guide, helping to influence the type of festival. But instead, they stood on the outside and say, wrong, hell, you know. And that is what they're still doing today. So those Christians who criticize crop over need to wheel and come. Yes, there are aspects of it that, you know, are negative, that needs reading out, okay? But instead of criticizing it and bringing judgment on the people, what can you do, okay, to make it a festival that is uplifting and that is truly a part of us, not only as black people, but as part of the human family, you know? And that's all I have to say for now on that matter. And I think that a more robust program should be mounted to encourage Barbadians to buy locally made goods, even if sometimes the price is a little higher. That keeps foreign exchange in the country and keep Barbadians employed. Moreover, that these businesses continue to succeed, eventually they will expand and employ more people, and they might even be in a position to export products and services sometime in the future. In my opinion, free trade is a myth. For while we have removed the barriers to trade in our markets, other countries have not been doing the same. I think that more protection should be offered to some types of businesses in the form of subsidies and tax relief. Look at the TNT Jamaica in this red death issue. No one cannot tell me that it had nothing at all to do with protecting their local airlines. So Barbadians only buy something from overseas if there is no local substitute. Imports, instead of decreasing, have actually increased. From the shoes you wear, the movies that you watch, the clothes that you wear, and the foods that you eat, when you don't buy local, you are draining down our foreign reserves, while our fledgling tourism market is not bringing in the foreign exchange as was the case in the past. Every single Bajan needs to be educated about the need to buy locally made goods and services, because if we don't do that, we are going to find ourselves in a real mess. We want to keep our current economic and social structure. We want to maintain the stability of our country. We don't want to go the route of laying off people in the public service, and we don't want to take other drastic measures like having people to pay for health care, having children to pay for parents rather to pay for their children's schooling. So we have to find other ways of doing that, you know. And I think that we need to support our own. More effort needs to be put into developing a viable manufacturing sector. And I think also that there's a definite need for more research and development. There needs to be a coordination of the current research facilities and research work, and so that there is a common purpose. So that at the end of the day, long term, okay, we can have a viable not only manufacturing sector, but also a viable industry in terms of science and technology, where we're able to export products and services that have been homegrown by our own people through our own innovation and creativity.